Hello everyone, myself Monira Khatun, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Mallabhum Institute of Technology, Bishnupur. In this video, I am going to give a brief introduction of line coding. What is line coding? It is the process of converting digital data to digital signals. Need of line coding. It is used to avoid overlap and distortion of signal such as ISI, inter-symbol interference. Properties of line coding. Transmission bandwidth. The transmission bandwidth must be as small as possible. Power efficiency. For a given bandwidth and specified detection error probability, the transmitted power for a line code should be as small as possible. Error detection and correction capability. It must be possible to detect and preferably correct detection errors. Adequate timing content. It must be possible to extract timing or clock information from the signal. Transparency. It must be possible to transmit a digital signal correctly, regardless of the pattern of ones and zeros. Types of line coding. There are three types of line coding techniques. One is the unipolar, second one is the polar, third one is the bipolar. There are two variations of line coding present. One is the return to zero, another is the non-return to zero. First, starting with the unipolar signaling. It is also called as on-off keying or OOK. The present of pulse represent A1 and the absence of pulse represent a zero. Now first go to the unipolar non-return to zero. In this type of signaling, a high in data is represented by a positive pulse called as mark, which has a duration T, which is equal to the symbol B duration, and a low in data input has no pulse. It is clearly understand with the help of the following figure. Next, go to the unipolar return to zero. In this signaling, a high in data, though represented by a mark pulse, its duration T is less than the symbol B duration. Half on the B duration remains high, but it immediately returns to zero and shows the absence of pulse during the remaining half of the B duration, which is clear in the figure. Now go to the polar signaling. In the signaling, a high in data is represented by a positive pulse, while a low in data is represented by a negative pulse. It is clearly understood in this figure. Polar non-return to zero. In the signaling, a high in data is represented by a positive pulse, while as a low in data is represented by a negative pulse, which is shown in the figure. Polar return to zero. In this signaling, a high data represented by a mark pulse. Its duration is T, which is less than the symbol B duration. Half of the B duration remains high, but it immediately returns to zero and shows the absence of pulse during the remaining half of the B duration. For a low input, a negative pulse represents the data and the zero level remains same for the other half of the B duration. Bipolar signal. This is an encoding technique which has three voltage levels, namely positive, negative and zero. Such a signal is called duo binary signal. It is also known as the AMI, alternate mark inversion. For a 1, the voltage level gets a transition from plus 1 to minus or from minus to plus, having alternate 1s to be of equal polarity. A 0 will have a 0 voltage level. Manchester. It is a line code in which the encoding of each data bit is either low then high or high then low. for equal time.